convention all about. But first, tell us, send my listening audience, who Jack the Rapper is.
Jack the Rapper, Jack Gibson. Very fine gentleman. One of our senior citizens in the industry. Former radio announcer. Jack Gibson has a tip sheet. He has a sheet that is almost like a Bible in the black record industry. And, like everybody subscribes to Jack the Rapper. That's where we get all our information. It keeps us abreast. You know, we only have two black trades, Jack the Rapper being a tip sheet, BRE. Sidney Miller being our actual magazine. Well, Sidney's more so eyes and ears for us, where Jack is truly the conscience. Jack will not let a little man get beat up. When I say beat up, I don't mean in the term of physical, without his paper jumping on them. Don't care who you are. And Jack has gained that reputation. The love of certain people of the way he's attracted to helping the little man, and the fear of some of the giants that they felt that would never ever fear this man because of that situation where he's a Japan is mightier than the sword.
Mm-hmm.
And he writes this, he's brought that type of situation, which is the reason why he sees the convention is jam packed. I mean, you can't even hardly move around. And it's basically because of what I said. Some come because they're loving. Some come because they're scared about this. Everybody talks about it. It's always good, man, anytime that, that my people and I can get together and vibe. It's always nice to see young black folks, men and women, thirsting and craving for knowledge, and to be able to, for them to be able to touch, feel the people that they've seen in the Jets and the Edmonds and on TV and radio, the whole thing. I mean, to be able to touch these people, when I say touch, to be able to be that close that they can ask questions and get answers, from people that they look up to and that they respect and admire. Because if you notice, you see quite a few big acts in there.
Yeah.
Barry White, for example, Isaac Hayes, Lionel Richie, LeBell,
yeah.
And if you notice, these people were not like they would be at a regular concert trying to slide through the door here in this way so the audience won't be able to grab them in trouble. They knew that they were amongst their own, man.
Yeah, no,
and they let themselves be exposed and they say, hey, on this turf, and this is what Jack's convention does,
uh-huh.
On that turf, no one is Big Chief. Everybody, feels in his own ears. He said, I've never seen the artists who have, you've heard rumors, you've seen in tip sheets and magazines about this artist is mad at this artist, and that artist is mad at that artist. And, producer likewise, and then when you get there and you sit them all sitting down, boom, hand in hand. Talking about positive things.
Okay, what direct effect does the convention have on the music business from your perspective?
Well, the direct effect that it has is basically the situation of his paper. His paper is the conscience of black. The black record industry.
All right, so you're saying that just being in his place automatically makes you that much more conscientious about your involvement in the business?
Yes, because you, like I just said, you can't come to Jack being phony.
Yeah.
And it gives everybody a chance to let their hair down. And you'd be surprised, you know, what you might find if you even let you yourself come out.
You took it upon yourself to organize this bus trip so that the Washington, D.C. community would be properly represented, I would think. That's one of your reasons for doing this. But I'd really like to know, what is your real motivation to do these kinds of things?
Black music is so important, and I'm sure that you are, well, I know you're aware, but I'm sure you understand the importance of what we've been talking about, that we've been asked by the chairman of the Black Music Association, by the corporate heads, to to get busy finding all the radio artists, you know, recording artists, songwriters, producers, retailers,
right.
Wholesalers,
right.
And media, TV, you know, the whole thing, prep, to get involved and let's start up the chapter
right.
of the BMA, Black Music Association, because they have recently started up chapters around the country. Something we need very bad. At BMA is, you know, since we're early, let me just take one more step. BMA is going to be very good in doing what we were talking about, carrying us along faster, because what BMA will be about is that the workshops, our chapter will function very properly, setting up workshops. We've got people at our disposal from national levels that will come in.
Sure.
You understand? I'm sure we can tap the sources from our universities here in town in reference to, you know, some of their professors, some of their knowledge.
Oh, yeah.
Law.
Right.
I mean, you know, entertainment law, the whole daggone thing. We'll do the total spectrum.
Right.
We're going to need the people that are serious and dedicated.
Oh, sure.
Because we got some work to do in the beginning. To start it up, I think after that, you're going to see a magnificent change in Washington, D.C.
The final question, where do we, the music business people in Washington go from here? Do we wait for BMA to give us, like, the show, or should we just feel that there's a group of people in the process of giving us the direction that we need? When I say us, I'm going to associate myself with all the other artists here in the city. Is that what's happening?
I never tell anybody to stop doing what they're doing.
Yeah.
But I always think you know what they're
doing. Yeah.
Whatever is to come, we'll catch up with you.
Sure.
Just always stay active. You may bump your head up against something trying to learn it, but it's better to bump your head and be in the game than to sit back and hold your head waiting on the game. You know what I mean? Sure, when BMA comes, it's going to be a great asset to take from going and carry on further and quicker. Excuse me. At the goal. But Washington will and then become a major entity in this record industry.
Again, I want to thank you for this few minutes. It's always a pleasure being in your company. And as we can look on, God willing, we will collectively be about making a positive contribution to the business of music. Thanks again, Max, and may God bless you.